Do you need analog gear to make great music? Listen to this and let's discuss.
It goes on.
Hi, I'm Andrew Barr, and welcome to Producing in the Box, where I teach you how to produce music using nothing else but your laptop or your PC. So let's get right into it. Producing in the box, what does that mean? So there's a musical term called producing in the box, where producers will have analog gear or they will have all plugins, software. That's called in the box if you do everything in your computer. Back in the day, and even still today, people will have modules that sit in racks and you plug microphones into it, guitars into it. They have preamps, compressors, EQs. I'm sure you've heard of some of these things if you're seeing this video and you're trying to figure out maybe which one's better. Should I invest in analog because it is expensive, or should I do everything in my computer but people tell me it doesn't sound that good? I'm here to tell you it's indistinguishable anymore. We are living in a digital age. So outboard versus plug-in. We have a rack unit that sits, a physical unit that you can hold on to and you can look at and plug your microphone into it. It's expensive, it's big, and it's a pain in the butt. You can get the same thing or something similar in a thing called a plugin, which is just software that runs in whatever digital audio workstation you like to use. Logic, Pro Tools, Studio One, Reaper, Cubase, it doesn't matter. The plugin just works right in your DAW. Okay, so do you need analog gear to make great music? No, you don't. Tons of people are not using analog gear anymore and they're doing everything right off of their laptop. Take a look at Phineas with Billie Eilish. I mean, he made that in his bedroom and is absolutely crushing it. You don't need this anymore. I mean, Lil Nas X recorded Old Town Road on a beat he bought for $30 online and recorded it into a crappy microphone into a computer. That was it. And the song blew up and he's signed now. So let's go into the pros and cons of analog versus digital, or in the box versus outboard gear. So I'm gonna start with the pros because I think it's great. It's cheaper, okay? Software is just cheaper. Someone can make it once, spend a lot of time on it once, and then they can just sell you a copy of it over and over and over again. Their overhead is lower. They don't have to make pieces and parts for this thing. If you buy it, you can use it on multiple tracks, so it's cheaper. If you have a head unit, a rack unit, and let's say you wanted to compress a stereo track coming in, a guitar's coming in with two different microphones on it, and you wanted to compress that, you'd have to buy a stereo compressor or two different compressors, and that's expensive. You can use one plugin, put it on one channel, put it on another channel. It's just that easy. So number two, it's fast. Like I said before, you can use multiple tracks for one plugin. I don't have to keep bouncing things or printing things into my session. You can use one plugin. I can also bounce things in real time, or I can bounce it faster than real time. 3-4 times faster is at least what my computer is able to do of printing out a song and getting it done for somebody faster than I would be able to if I had a head unit. If I had a compressor going into my computer and I ran it back out, back into the compressor, then ran it back in, I'd have to print every track. I have 70, 80, 90 tracks in some of these sessions. It's massive. It would take me forever. I can just put a plugin on it and I can click bounce and it bounces the song back out to me and it sounds fantastic. Number three, it's mobile. I can take a laptop and a pair of headphones and I can go anywhere. I could be on the beach, I could be in a plane, I could be at my parents' house, I could be hanging out at Taco Bell, munching on a taco, mixing music for my new band. I can go anywhere and I have all of my gear with me and I don't have to worry about powering it. I don't have to worry about anything. I just bring my laptop, pair of headphones, and I go to town. It's amazing. So obviously if we're gonna have pros and cons, we're gonna have cons, and there are some cons, and I'll get into that. So number one is the processing power of your computer. it can only handle so much. So if you put enough plugins on there, it might start to bog down a little bit, but there's a way around it. You just bounce it down. Just bounce each one of those down, and then your computer can handle it because you're not running that plugin in real time anymore. Easy workaround, and it's still quicker than dealing with analog, at least in my personal experience and opinion. That's about it. That's it. That's the only con that I have with the digital age of music. It sounds indistinguishable. It sounds so good. No one's arguing about whether it sounds better than analog anymore. They might be saying it sounds different, but is anybody arguing whether it sounds better or not anymore? No. Somebody might. There's always those couple people. But I'm telling you right now, the people that are crushing it right now don't care. They're not gonna care. They're making great music, and they don't care what tools they use, just as long as it gets the job done. We are living in an age of music access for everybody. No longer do the massive studios and record labels gatekeep the talent that you have. It's in your hands now. So, go create.